the showplace of the nation, the Radio City Music Hall, for the centennial celebration of the Actors Fund of America, the night of 100 stars, and then some. Stage in one theater in one evening had this many world-renowned artists appeared. 200 stars of film, television, stage, music, variety, ballet, opera, and sports. Celebrate with us tonight as we count the stars. Rockettes one.
I don't know. I think I just twisted it. Oh, I hope it's not sprained or broken.
Okay, now just sit here until after the number's over. I'll get you down to the nurse. It's probably nothing serious. Stage manager to nurse. Injured bird. Electrics. Cue coming up.
Oh, just my luck. I meant to ask you anyway. What is this for tonight? This isn't our regular show.
Hang on, I got a cue. Electrics. Ready cue 5. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Go! Yeah, this whole show's for the Actors Fund of America, celebrating their 100th birthday.
They must be pretty special, huh? For all these stars to turn out?
I'll say. Hang on. Here they come. Stage crew, get ready for the Doobie Brothers. Close in the front curtain. Warn Orson Welles.
Night of 100 Stars is brought to you by...
just a sprain, but you'll be grounded for a while. Why don't you just stay here and watch the Night of 100 Stars on television?
Okay, thanks. What is the Actors Fund of America? Do you know?
I sure do. It's the oldest theatrical charity in the world, and it aids the needy in show business. Not just actors, as you might think, but the entire entertainment community. Dancers, circus and opera and television performers, ushers, stagehands, designers. For over 100 years,
across the country, has been confidentially assisting those professionals who are in distress. The fund has drawn on the instinctive generosity of show people, and tonight is no exception. They've turned out with spirit and enthusiasm to celebrate this centennial by entertaining you royally in this magnificent hall.
Thank you. city. It's lovely going through the zoo. It's very fancy on old Delancey Street, you know. The subway charms us so, where balmy breezes blow to and fro. Tell me what street compares with Mott Street in July. Sweet pushcarts gently gliding by. The great big city's a wondrous toy, just made for a girl and boy. We'll turn Manhattan into an Isle of
of September, when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and the grain was yellow. Try kind of September when you were young and a callow fellow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow, around the heart of
Good evening. I'm so pleased to be a part of this evening's tribute to the Actors Fund and to the wonderful work they have been doing for the past 100 years. They've been remarkable years, full of courage and wonder, upheaval and distress, change and continuity. Tonight, as we celebrate in song and dance and laughter, the contributions that have been made by the people of the entertainment world, we will remind ourselves of some of the highlights of this century past. In 1883, when a candle was lighted for the first birthday of the Actors Fund of America, people were talking about the brand new Brooklyn Bridge and a canal that the French were starting to build across the Isthmus of Panama. Robert Louis Stevenson wrote Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Grover Cleveland was president, and in the nation's capital, the Washington Monument was completed. Across the ocean, Queen Victoria celebrated her golden jubilee, and Sir Arthur Conan Doyle wrote the first Sherlock Holmes. George Eastman perfected the first Kodak box camera, and Tchaikovsky wrote his Fifth Symphony. In Paris, Gustav Eiffel built a tower. The last major conflict between US troops and the Indians was fought at the Battle of Wounded Knee, and Idaho and Wyoming joined the Union. In 1891, a man named Judson patented a device that he called a zipper, and a YMCA instructor invented a game that he called basketball. And in 1892, when the Actors Fund was 10 years old, the University of Chicago was founded, and Mr. Tchaikovsky wrote the Nutcracker Suite.
Each other's arms, I'm here to love you.
1893, the Actors' Fund was 11 years old. Henry Ford built his first car, and Thomas Alva Edison produced a machine called the kinetoscope, which made motion pictures possible. Thank you, Mr. Edison. The Republic of Hawaii was proclaimed, and Rudolph Valentino and Babe Ruth were born. A man named Gillette invented the safety razor, and McKinley was elected president. In 1897, Queen Victoria celebrated her Diamond Jubilee, and the Actors Fund was 15 years old. The Spanish-American War broke out, and Colonel Teddy Roosevelt and his Rough Riders charged up the San Juan Hill. In one 12-month period, George Gershwin, Fred Astaire, Humphrey Bogart, Noel Coward, and Duke Ellington were born. The beginning of the 20th century in 1900 saw the United States with a population of 76 million. Teddy Roosevelt was now vice president. 1901, McKinley was assassinated, and Teddy Roosevelt became president. In 1902, the U.S. took over the building of the Panama Canal. The first Rose Bowl game was played, and the Actors Fund was 20 years old.
Welcome to America's favorite panel show. We are here to guess your occupation. I'm your host, Hal Linden, and I want to know.
What's your mind?
So do all the people in the nation. Our distinguished panel is here tonight, here at my request, to solve the mystery of the year tonight, to guess the mystery guest. Now meet the panel, the panel of experts who always do so fine when it comes to guessing. What's your line?
What's your line?
We want to know what's your line. First you'll see Michelle Lee, straight from the Great Knots Landing Show.
And I'm so proud to be with Gavin McLeod, for he's the one that makes the love boat go.
And by my side is Mork's new bride, sweet Pam Dauber is Mindy, you know.
And next to me, who do we see? From Too Close for Comfort,
Too Close for Comfort,
you ready?
Yes, we are ready to guess the mystery star.
Are your blindfolds in place so nobody sees?
Yes, they are.
Then come in, mystery guest, and sign in, please. Begin the questioning with you, Michelle.
Okay, are you young and attractive, macho, sexy, and free?
That's well, not the way we play our little game, Michelle.
Oh, well, you play your little game and leave the guests to me.
Let me ask you, are you bigger than a bread box?
Yes.
Is there some kind of service you perform?
Oh, yes.
Can we use the kind of service you're performing?
Uh-huh.
I don't know about the rest of you, but I am getting warm.
Do you have another question for our guest, Michelle?
Yes, I do, but I can't say it on the air. Oh,
is it possible that you could be a dancer?
Yes.
Are you Ben Vereen, Gene Kelly,
Fred Astaire?
Yes and no.
Then perhaps you also sing a little?
Yes, I do.
Uh-huh.
And you also do some acting down the line?
That is true.
Are you witty and amusing?
Now and then I am.
I've just one more question.
Yes?
Your place or mine?
I'm afraid our panel isn't very hot tonight.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. That's exactly true.
This panel's always way ahead of me, but not tonight. And so I'll ask our guests to give to you a teeny tiny subtle little clue. Now try not to reveal your identity, but won't you tell our panel what you do? I'm a receptionist.
You're a receptionist?
At a station known as WKRP. And I'm a butler.
What kind of butler?
On the two of us, I buttle for my fee.
I drive a taxi.
You drive a taxi.
I stand dispatch them into and fro and on their way. I'm a domestic.
Give me a break, please.
I don't do windows, but I really earn my pay.
And I'm a waitress.
What kind of waitress?
They call me Alice, and I'm good at slinging hash. I'm also Benson.
And what do you do?
I run the governor and I budget out the cash. And I'm a hostess.
Why, that's incredible!
I talk with people from the east, west, north, and south. My game is football.
The Monday night pie.
Yes, I got my big shot by shooting off my mouth. I'm a cartoonist.
A real cartoonist?
Sometimes I get too close for comfort with my jokes. And I'm an artist.
Commercial artist?
They all upset me, cause deep down I'm just plain folks. I've earned a fortune.
You're into finance.
I built a dynasty my wife and I can share. Play detective.
Is that fulfilling?
I'll tell you, heart to heart, there's lots of wear and tear. I'm Mr. Merlin.
The great magician.
I get my kicks by doing tricks no one has tried. I'm a pathologist.
What?
A criminologist.
Uh-huh.
Just call on Quincy if you think you might have died. I'm an investment.
Are you from Dallas?
My wife's a lush and I'm JR, the local louse. And I'm a school marm, a prairie school marm. But I help out a lot around our little house. I own a diner.
Thumbs up on that job.
These days are happy days for me without a wife. House mother's my job.
Do you enjoy it?
The girls I watch are teaching me the facts of life. And I can nurse you in case you're ailing. And I'm a doctor.
Did you say doctor?
Uh-huh.
If I could capture Trevor John, my mom would melt.
If we need someone to clean and press us, just call the Jeffersons and I will make you neat.
And if we're lonely and need attention,
you know the company of three is hard to beat. I'm a policeman.
A real policeman?
I work on Hill Street and those hills are sure alive. And I'm a lady.
A racy lady?
I
Bruce Flamingo Road, and I supply the drive.
Hey, Michelle, I'm a breeder.
Oh, do you breed horses?
We horsed around and put King's Crossing on the map. Laverne is my name, and I'm a rapper. When I make trouble, my friend Shirley takes the rap. Panel, have you guessed it? Guess the mystery guest.
We have no idea who it could be.
Well, let me flip the cards then. Remove the blindfolds, please. And here's our mystery guest for you to see. John Schneider.
I'm just the symbol of the stars, the best you've ever seen.
The five-time all-time TV star who breaks your TV screen. We are here to entertain you. That's our line.
That's our line. Entertain and
Sistine Chapel is designed by Francis Ford Coppola.
I'm here, America. 15 years ago, I come here with the name Ivan Goliva Sovietavieva, but you can call me Chuck. My God, look, Tiffany's blew up. It's the history of jewelry. We do have another announcement. They are selling the Ronald Reagan Memorial Pens, the commemorative pen. The only strange thing is that it has no point. Don't be afraid. Also, if you look at the recent money being printed now, instead of "In God We Trust," it just says, "Trust me." Don't be afraid. They said to bring tails, so I brought this. Put this down here. Look, you paid $1,000. Big deal. This is scary, but fun. Oh, little Japanese man. Take the Walkman off, sir. This time, we won't need the Pearl Harbor. You won't hear us coming. Thank you all for coming this evening. It's for a very worthy cause. I hope that one day, if I live 30 years from now, I can go to that special hospital that'll be built, because instead of being somewhere downtown going, "Remember me, Ninny Ninny, give me $50 for a bottle of Dom Perignon." And be there in the hospital with all my friends. "Brooke, Brooke Shields, how are you? Your eyebrows finally grew together. Look at that." Don't be afraid. "There, my other, look at that, my old rock and roll friends over there snorting Maalox. Come on." "Yeah, it's all right over there. Things are going to be okay. They just elected the new president, Monty Hall. It's going to be okay. He has a new foreign policy called 'Let's Make a Detente.' You have a choice of taking free will or what's behind the Iron Curtain. But don't worry, I'm going to be okay here. This hospital, all friends, I'm going. Thanks for giving me a place to stay.
Sorry.
Oh.
What's happening?
Oh, nothing. I'm just fine, thank you. Just fine.
Okay, allow me to introduce myself. I am Placido Domingo.
Placido Domingo?
Yes.
What do you do?
I am an opera singer, you know. Sometimes I sing.
Ah, terrific. That's all I need, competition.
And you are, of course, who else but Miss Piggy?
Yes, I'm sorry, I can't. I'm too upset.
But what is the matter, Miss Piggy?
I miss my frog.
You miss your frog?
Yes.
What a thing to talk about to an opera singer, a frog.
No, I mean Kermit the Frog.
Kermit the Frog?
Yes.
Of course, now I get it, yes.
I'm just not good at these minor functions without him.
What can I do to help you?
You could help me. You think you could possibly say, "Hey ho, Kermit the Frog here, and welcome to the Muppet Show. Please.
Well,
Superstar's begging, please.
Miss Piggy, I do anything to please you.
Oh, yes.
I am going to try, okay?
Yes.
But you know I'm not green.
I know.
Okay. I don't have flippers.
I know.
Okay. And listen, I don't eat flies, you
I'll
know.
I'll take the chance.
Okay.
Okay, yes, yes, yes.
Okay, here yes. It goes. Hey-ho, I'm Kermit the Frog, and welcome to the Muppet Show. Hey! Oh, Piggy.
Oh, Apicito. When you travel, don't you miss home Emperor?
Well, Miss Piggy, let me tell you something. When you really love someone,
yes.
It doesn't matter. You never leave them. They really live in your heart always,
yes.
You know?
Yes.
Nevertheless, you know, you are rushing from the airport to the opera house, then to the hotel, rehearsals, performance,
yes.
And sometimes a day goes by, one whole entire day, when I don't think of her. 24 hours pass, I look around and find that I haven't thought of her, not even when I'm somewhere we used to go, not even if there's someone we used to know. It's hardly every day, it's most unusual in fact. I can't remember where, but sometimes a day goes by and I don't think of her till morning comes, and then
In 1903, Wilbur and Orville Wright got that airplane off the ground in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, and the Actors Fund was 21 years old. Because there was a fair there, everyone was singing Meet Me in St. Louis, and the first subway was opened in New York City. The first copy of the show business Bible, Variety, hit the stands, and in 1906, earthquake and fire destroyed two-thirds of San Francisco. The Merry Widow opened on Broadway, and a Russian named Pavlov used dogs to study conditioned reflexes. The Actors Fund was 25 years old. Henry Ford put the Model T on the market for $850.50. Baseball regulations outlawed the spitball, and the FBI was established. Robert Peary discovered the North Pole, and William Howard Taft became president. The Boy Scouts of America were founded, and Halley's Comet was observed. The The first transcontinental airplane flight from Pasadena to New York took 3.5 days with refueling stops along the way. In 1912, the Actors Fund was 30 years old and movies were becoming a popular form of entertainment. That year, two acting sisters, Lillian and Dorothy Gish, joined the Biograph Company and were among the first movie queens.
I'd like you to meet Harvey. Harvey, you've heard me speak of Aunt Ethel Chauvenet. She's one of my oldest and dearest friends. She's the one who... Hmm? That's right. Well, this is the one. No, she's the one.
Well, I'm not licked. And I'm gonna stay right here and fight for this lost cause. Even if this room gets filled with lies like these. And the tailors and all their armies come marching into this place. Somebody will listen to me.
Good idea, Ernie. A toast. To my big brother, George, the richest man in town.
Boys.
Hey, what is the score anyway?
Oh, so it's you he was after. He's in love with a woman with wings. She's got him. I've no way to cut her out.
But there's another road.
Yes, there is. And we're on it. I look
terrible.
Who says so?
Is it fair of you to bust in on us like this?
I phoned you from Portland.
Yes, but you said you wouldn't be home for a...
We were lucky. We got a plane to Welburn. I thought we were going to get stuck there, but we came right through.
Al, are you all right?
Sure. Are you all right?
Oh, of course I am.
Give me humility, Lord. After all, it was only thy merciful goodness and thy divine providence that saved the boy. But they are ungrateful, and you know it.
You're asking for trouble, Mr. Ringo.
You already got it, partner. Because I got a gun on you under this table, and it's pointing smack at your belly. Now, you gonna get out of here or not?
I'm kind of disappointed in you, Mr. Ringo. We heard a lot about you around here, but I guess they forgot to tell us about the gun under the table.
The older you grow, the more you learn, son. Now turn around and head for the door. So, a quiet, humble, respectable Negro who has had the unmitigated temerity to feel sorry for a white woman has had to put his word against two white peoples. The defendant is not guilty. But somebody in this courtroom is.
You needn't worry about me. I'm free white and 21, almost. And I'll go on loving you from here on out. Or until I stop loving you. But nobody owes a thing to Kitty Foyle. Except Kitty Foyle.
Hello, Bill. Don't be sentimental. Remember, you're a ham at heart.
No, that wasn't me. It was a friend of mine. How's the new job coming on?
Would you like me to carry a message to your late lamented Aunt Susan?
Hold on. Gangrene just set in. No message. I don't use that kind of language.
One ball, corner pocket. Yeah, percentage players die broke too, don't they, Bert?
What the hell are you doing here?
Details? That what you want?
Details. Okay.
They found her naked in the tub.
God, she didn't even want to make a mess. No water, just naked in the tub.
You interested in her? You interested in how she felt?
Yes.
Okay, she picks up a newspaper, for Christ's sake. And there it is for everybody to see. Everybody to look at it. She must have felt like she flew.
4-9. Four jacks. You owe me 15 grand, pal.
What's the matter, kiddo? You like my face?
Look at that.
All right. I'll jump first.
Nope.
Then you jump first.
No, I said.
What's the matter with you?
I can't swim!
Why, are you crazy? The fall will probably kill you.
What a dump.
I'd like to kiss you, but I just washed my hair.
And after you kiss me, I always used to wipe my mouth. Wipe my mouth!
I put on this white dress for you. To help me tell you how humbly I ask you to forgive me.
Well, I think I have a large order of prognosis negative.
Oh, Jerry, don't let's ask for the moon. We have the stars.
Fasten your seatbelts. It's going to be a bumpy night.
You asked me to pull an act, turn yellow, so those kids will think I'm no good. You asked me to throw away the only thing I got left, the only thing I've been able to take away from me. You want me to give those newspaper synopsists a chance to say another act turn yellow.
You're a smart boy, Roberts. But I know how to take care of smart boys. I hate your guts, you smart college guys. I've been seeing your kind around since I was 10 years old. Working as a busboy. Oh, busboy, it seems my friend is thrown up on the table. Clean up that best boy, will ya?
And people keep telling me you're a worthless piece of slime.
Hold on! You can't talk to me like that!
Shut up, boy! Buddy.
Oh, I'm going crazy with love.
I'm your knight shining armor, and I love you. You have made me what I am, and I am yours. My love, there's so many ways I want to say I love you. You have come into my world and made me whole.
The good news was that the Actors' Fund was 31 years old. But 1913 began with a constitutional amendment which gave the U.S. government the right to tax personal incomes. Things certainly didn't get better the next year because an Austrian Archduke was assassinated in Sarajevo, Yugoslavia, and the First World War began. And long-distance telephone service was inaugurated between New York and San Francisco. The big hit song was Hello, Frisco. Woodrow Wilson was re-elected president. The 1916 theatrical sensation was Mr. Ziegfeld's Follies. In 1917, the first American troops arrived in Germany. George M. Cohan wrote a song called Over There. Buffalo Bill Cody died. The armistice was signed on November 11, 1918, signaling the end of the war. In 1919, the 18th Amendment to the Constitution was passed, outlawing the manufacture and sale of intoxicating liquors. In 1920, the 19th Amendment gave women the vote. Warren Harding was elected president, and regular licensed radio broadcasting began. The next year, the big hit show on Broadway was Shuffle Along with Josephine Baker, with a song we still sing, I'm Just Wild About Harry. In 1922, a magazine called The Reader's Digest was founded, and Benito Mussolini was named Premier of Italy. Eugene O'Neill won the Pulitzer Prize for Anna Christie, and the Actors Fund was 40 years old.
Everybody. It's a great challenge for a magician to perform on this Radio City Music Hall stage. So we're going to have to do something very, very special this evening. I've decided on a little variation of a great classic of magic. This evening I'm going to saw two women in half. And in order to do this illusion, I need some very special assistance. First of all, we need some strength, some brawn. So I asked my old friend Ricky Schroeder to come and help me. Hi there, Ricky.
How you doing?
I'm doing great.
I'm all set. I've been doing all my push-ups.
Good.
How does that feel?
That feels great.
Am I the only one?
No, no. Now that we have the brawn, we need some brains. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome Maureen Stapleton. Yeah. Hi, Maureen.
Thank you. Hi, Ricky. Well, I think we better get started because we have two very lovely ladies with very cold feet.
These are the ones who are going to be sawn in half. Ladies and gentlemen, the beautiful Florence Henderson. Hi there, Florence.
Well, hi, Doug. Good evening, everybody. I hope.
Why do you have cold feet? That dress looks nice and warm to me.
Oh. Now, beautiful Priscilla Lopez.
I'm really a chicken, and I want you to know the only reason I'm doing this is because of the Actors Fund.
Right.
Well, if it's any comfort, if anything goes wrong, the Actors Fund is always there.
It's good to know.
Thank you, Maureen.
Ladies and gentlemen, prepare for the double sawing a woman in half.
Okay.
We need the capes and the shoes. It's a very dangerous illusion. The incredible double sawing a woman in half. No, come back. It's not dangerous. Right back here into the magical operating room. Ladies, just slide down in here. It's not going to hurt a bit. It's all done by magic.
Hi.
Closing the doors. Let's close them in there. Sometimes the girls get a little nervous when they see the saw. So we have little footstocks for their little foots. Florence, you have ticklish foots there. There we go. Good. That'll lock them in. Okay, we also have some headstocks. You each get a headstock. That'll make it nice and comfortable. There we go. Good. Now for the exciting part. Ricky, go get the stainless steel, very fragile, delicate surgical instrument. Bring out the saw. Yeah, the saw, Ricky, that's the one with the teeth. We'll do that a little later. This is a fragile thing here. Good. Look at the teeth on that saw. Okay, Maureen, test the saw here. Make sure it's all right.
Oh, my God. Maureen.
You ready, ladies? Here we go. Sawing a woman in half. Take a deep breath, Florence. It won't hurt a bit there. There we go.
I knew I should.
That's one.
Leg. Oh.
Double your pleasure, double your fun. Yeah.
Oh.
That's right. You push when I pull. That works better that way. Now, to complete this song, we have these stainless steel surgical blades. There we go.
Take it easy.
Priscilla, a couple for you here.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's stuck. I'll fix that.
Oh.
How are you doing in there? Good. Still alive? Moving around?
Oh.
And you, Florence? Now for my favorite part. Doesn't that look weird? Now let's put them back together again. Just grab a piece here. Let's see what we can do.
It feels weird, Doug.
Woo!
All of
me. Where are you going, Maureen?
Why not take all of me?
There we go. This is right. Yep, just close the old doors there. Okay. How are we doing with these, Ricky? Good. Florence, I think you're going to be a little bit shorter with these legs. Close the doors. Okay, remove the blades. Take the blades out there. Well, how'd you feel?
I felt nothing.
Okay, bring her over here, Ricky. It's time to remove the headstocks.
Okay.
Good. Now the footstocks, and We're in business. Let's see if the operation's been a success. Open the doors.
In 1923, as the 20s roared along, Calvin Coolidge became president, George Gershwin wrote The Rhapsody in Blue, and the biggest hit on Broadway was No, No, Nanettes. Congress approved citizenship for all American Indians. J. Edgar Hoover was made director of the FBI, and Wyoming and Texas elected women governors. The Charleston dance craze spread across the country. F. Scott Fitzgerald wrote The Great Gatsby. One of the best pictures of that year was Phantom of the Opera. And in the dry USA, $3.5 billion of bootleg booze was consumed, and A.A. Milne wrote Winnie the Pooh. Motion pictures began to talk with The Jazz Singer, starring Al Jolson. Charles Lindbergh flew New York to Paris in 33 hours, and the Actors Fund was then 45 years old. Herbert Hoover became president, and Fleming discovered penicillin. Walt Disney's Mickey Mouse made his debut, and Amelia Earhart was the very first woman to fly the Atlantic alone. In 1929, the hit song was Happy Days Are Here Again. But in October of that year, the Wall Street stock market collapse signaled the end of the Roaring Twenties. The Great Depression stalked the nation. All Quiet on the Western Front won the Academy Award, and if you were still singing, you were singing on the sunny side of the street. The Empire State Building opened, and after 117 years, Congress finally passed a law making the Star-Spangled Banner our national anthem. In 1932, there were bread lines and soup kitchens, and brother, can you spare a dime? Nevertheless, the Radio City Music Hall opened its doors for the first time, and the Actors Fund chalked up half a century of service.